what do you see out there? What kind of opportunities? You are the chairman of the Export Development Board here in Sri Lanka, and your eyes are, you know, looking out there. Where can we pretty much get an opportunity and keep pushing ourselves to a better state? What do you see?
Mahesh, I think Sri Lanka needs a good brand. I think the world needs to see something positive about Sri Lanka. I think our relationship with India is going to, the perception Sri Lankans have about India is going to be different. Okay, now we are trying to sell our products in China when we have an equally good market right next door to us. Okay, but why are we? Because we think of India also as in a negative way. Okay,
India
is India, right? But if we looked at the economy of India and what's happening in India, I mean, if I were to tell you that Tamil Nadu is the third largest producer of automobiles in the world, you might look at India differently, right? And you say the most number of millionaires that are being created every day is in India. Then you look at India differently, okay? So I think that these are the kinds of mindset, the reset that needs to happen, okay? We need to look at these opportunities. And I was talking about the branding. And the other is our 100% chemical-free agriculture. I don't think Sri Lanka can have a better brand than that. I think
that's an
I can't think of a better opportunity than that. Okay, I have been on talk shows long time ago where I said if I own Sri Lanka, the first thing I would do is to make it chemical free.
But there is a question: can we do that? You know, can we go 100% organic? Is it a possibility?
Why not? Okay, like anything else, there will be short-term implications. If everybody pulls in that direction, okay, and the government, His Excellency, has promised to support us to do it, right? If everybody was to pull in that direction, imagine in 3 to 4 years, Sri Lanka will be certified chemical-free or certified organic, okay? And then The biggest issue with organic is people don't believe it. Okay, everywhere in the world, people use the organic word quite
because they're used to the easy way.
Yeah. Well, no. I'm talking about the brand organic.
Ah.
Okay, we don't pay enough for it. Okay, but if we knew for sure that organic is 100% certified organic, I mean that's what it's supposed to mean, is that it's organic certified. The name term organic means organic certified. Right?
One more thing is that when it comes to organic stuff and all those things, you know, we are only looking at the European market or the American market. Is that
even in the local market, if we could believe that our food is 100% organic, we will pay more money for it, for sure. But we don't trust. We don't trust it 100%. Okay?
We don't trust us,
right?
Our own country.
And even stuff that's coming from abroad that claims to be organic, you have to check the but in the next few years, it's going to change. Because now we have a concept called traceability,
yes.
Where we have a QR code on our food products. And you can trace it to where it was grown. And this concept of single origin, unadulterated, okay? Now, India is the largest producer of or exporter of spices in the world. And my buyers, I'm in the trade, so I know, my buyers say if it is made in India, it could be made anywhere because they mix it so much, right? So now we have Ceylon cinnamon, which is the world's best.
Yes.
And 80% of the world market for true cinnamon is Sri Lanka. Then we have world's best tea. We also have world's best black pepper. This is, you know, no argument about this. Now, where are we selling this to? You know, who are we selling this to? Are we getting the premium markets where, you know, the Lamborghini drivers are buying our product, or are the Maruti drivers buying our product?
Does that matter?
Huh?
Does that matter?
Yes, it's the price. Okay, if we can sell our product to a premium market, we can get a better price. And our farmers need to get the benefit from that.